G'day ladies and gents, welcome to War Thunder with Mags, and welcome to Absolute Simulator Battles. Yes, this is the event that is currently running, testing a new form of simulator battle with no target markers or anything else, really. Been getting asked what my opinion is on this game mode ever since this event popped up, and I bloody love it. Gaijin have outdone themselves here. This is exactly what I wanted from my War Thunder. Now, I did have some massive problems with this game mode when it first came out, and this was the battle that actually made me see exactly what Gaijin is trying to do here. I agree with almost everything they've done. Now, I'm going to take a shot at this P3 up here at the moment. I'm not actually trying to shoot it down, believe it or not. This match, I'm actually squatted up in a four-man squad. Except we're not all on the ground. I'm in my command Panzer IV. I've got Captain 544 off to my left flanking around the buildings trying to get angle on the IS-1s that are at the end of this street, and there are two of them, in his Jag Panzer 70A. And I have Grievous and Semper Mortem overhead. Grievous is currently flying a BF-109 F-4, and that's what firing that shell at the PE-3 was all about. I was actually pointing a line at the PE-3 that I wanted Grievous to shoot down. And Semper Mortem's in a Stuka D-5 with a heavy bomb load. So what we have here is a four-man squad, completely mixed forces. We've got close-in brawl and long-range sniping on the ground, as well as air superiority and tactical ground strike capability from the air, and we're all on comms. And this battle absolutely had me pumped. What you see on screen is only a very small portion of what's happening at this very moment. For instance, at this moment, I'm engaging two IS-1s at the end of the street. However, Captain 544 is attempting to flank through the buildings to the left-hand side. I've just taken a hit, so I'm going to pull back an artillery strike. Now, I'm not entirely sure exactly where they're sitting down that street accurately, so I've put it in a spot where I think is close, but just ahead of them, so the artillery strikes will provide smoke cover. That smoke cover is also going to allow Captain 544 to get between the buildings that are up the street to get around the side of the IS-1, so he can take out one while I take out the other. From the air, Semper Mortem is currently looking at a bomb strike angle to be able to actually drop three 250 kilo bombs on top of these IS-1s at the end of the street to clear the street if necessary. And while that's going on, Grievous is currently engaging an IL-2 as well as the PE-3 to make sure they can't get down here to bomb out me and Captain 544 for the IS-1s. So the German glass barrel strikes again. I'm currently sitting in repair waiting for a new barrel to get screwed on. It shouldn't take me too long, I got a pretty good crew on this tank. And this is one of those battles that I really wish I'd been recording comms the whole way through, because it was intense, because Grievous was updating us on what he was doing. Semper was calling out for detailed positions so he could set himself up to start dropping bombs to take out targets, telling us when he's available and he's got reloaded bombs available, when he's had to break off and use the D5's maneuverability and 20mm cannons to convince IL-2s that they really shouldn't be in the area. Every time Captain was getting into position and needed to either flush somebody out or was getting ready to shoot and wanted me to move out of the way, he was letting me know. It was brilliant. Now, I've told you guys all of this because I want to make it perfectly clear. I love this game mode. I want it to stay. I don't want them to stop it. I know it's only supposed to be around for a limited time for testing. I want them to make it permanent. Even once the testing's done, they've got their information. Just leave the event run, please. Don't remove it. That said, there are some things within this game mode that drastically need to be changed. And it would, just to make it even better. They're exploitative, I suppose is the best way to put it. There's issues involving balance, and well, they're things that need to be corrected because it is ruining the fun for a lot of people at the moment. So the first thing we're going to discuss is aircraft. Now, to be clear, I'm not one of those people who thinks aircraft should be removed from this event. In fact, I think removing aircraft from this event would break it. It would turn it into just another simulator mode without markers. It would make it batshit boring. A huge amount of the adrenaline rush I get out of this is working with aircraft and pilots in aircraft, and having to watch out for enemy pilots in aircraft. However, there is a couple of small issues with the way they're currently implemented in the game mode. First things first, now you can take two vehicles into the game mode, you get two respawns. The idea is you can take in one tank and you can take in one aircraft. Makes complete sense, that would be perfectly fine, except it causes a problem. Now, I understand how hard it is to fly aircraft in sim. In fact, you're going to see me flying aircraft in sim in this video. This should be the balancing point for aircraft. They're hard to fly, so they shouldn't be too overpowered. However, to do what people are doing with them in the game mode at the moment, you don't need to be incredibly skilled. What they're doing is loading up a ground attacker, something that carries a lot of bombs. IL-2s seem to be popular for this, the PE-3Bs, and of course the Stukas are the ones that they're using. Now, when you spawn in an aircraft, you get the option of spawning from the airfield. Incredibly difficult, because you have to take off, obviously. Ooh, that's gonna leave a mark. And as I was saying, sim battle takeoffs are incredibly difficult, because you are inside of the cockpit, which means you can't actually see where you're going down the runway most of the time. You have to account for top prop torque on most of the aircraft. The aircraft will try and wander all over the runway. Simply trying to get it off the ground and seeing where the end of the runway is quite difficult. And it's actually even worse in this game mode, because you have no idea exactly what your airspeed is unless you know how to read your own gauges. This should be a major issue for pilots who are inexperienced actually being able to use the planes within this game. Except you don't have to take off. You have the option of just spawning directly into the air with any aircraft. Now, the air spawn spawns you in at a couple of thousand feet over the top of your own runway. It spawns you in at almost maximum level flight speed, and you are spawned in with the aircraft already pre-trimmed for level flight. So all you need with the mouse cursor and using a simple mouse joystick is to point the plane in the approximate direction of the enemy team's spawn and push it into a dive. You will be able to get your aircraft to the enemy team's spawn long before the enemy tanks have managed to clear out of the open ground that they appear in at the start of the match. And you can see what's coming. Inexperienced pilots are quite easily able to use their sim-controlled aircraft with massive payloads loaded underneath them as effectively guided missiles against heavy tanks. Now, why are they targeting heavy tanks? And I'm looking at IS-1s and KV-2s for the Russian side, and of course, the almighty Tiger for the German side. Well, they don't get respawns, so why the inexperienced pilot, who was only using his plane to basically kamikaze the first hostile large enemy tank he could find, only loses a plane and then drives out in his tank, the enemy player that he kamikazed is permanently out of the ground battle. He has nothing else that he can deploy. He can potentially deploy an aircraft and fight back, but without having a tank on the ground, before the ground battle has even started, he's lost any ability to have any major influence within it. He can't cap points with an aircraft. So, game-breaking issue. It is infuriating for whichever team's having it done, for players that have just lost their tanks and been waiting in queue to try and get into one of these battles, and have just lost their heavy tank right at the start of the match, within seconds of the battle starting. How do you fix it? Well, there are two things that need to be done. First things first, teams need to be limited to no more than 6 aircraft per team. There needs to be no respawns. If you decide to deploy an aircraft into a battle, that's it. If you get shot down, you're out of the battle. You cannot deploy a tank anymore. So you've got to choose what you deploy into battle very wisely. And the air spawn needs to be removed for all aircraft. Every aircraft in the game needs to use the runways if they want to get off the ground. And that there is what close air support from a D5 Stuka looks like. Now, I'm sure bomber pilots are going to complain about starting on the runways. Honestly, guys, deal with it. Your ground targets are player tanks. They're trapped in a tiny little arena in the middle of the match, and they have a top speed of 40 kilometers an hour. They're not going anywhere. You don't need an air spawn to be able to catch them. And the excuse of, oh, but the fighters will beat us there if we don't have an air spawn and shoot us down, doesn't fly either, because the fighters beat you there anyway, because you only start over the top of your runway. A Focke-Wulf 190 can take off from the German runway, lift up and fly at 100 feet to the centre spawn and actually beat its own Stukas to the centre point of the map. Now, those three changes, the first one, limiting the teams to no more than 6 aircraft apiece, prevents running into situations where one team is all aircraft and one team is all tanks. At the most, you'll only have 6 aircraft on the enemy team, and you should have that many yourself. Removing the pilot's ability to respawn in a tank means that only serious pilots will take up the air role or the air support role within War Thunder ground battles. Nobody's going to be picking them up to use them as guided missiles because there's no point for it. And of course, removing the air spawn means that those serious pilots cannot make it to the spawn points faster than it takes for the heavy tanks to be able to get out of them, out of the open areas that they spawn in, and into cover around the edges of the map, whether that be a tree line, a ravine, whatever they can find to try and provide themselves with some defense from air forces and make themselves hard to see from the air. So what about ground forces? Well, ground forces has a slight imbalance as well between the Russians and the Germans. And this is something that has been called out on many a time, and I'm going to just relist it here. I'm not the first one to mention this, and I'm sure I won't be the last. Now, the most popular tank on the German side is obviously the Tiger. It's the mighty Tiger. Everybody loves this thing. It gets one spawn, but nobody cares. It's a Tiger. It's not surprising at all. What about the Russian side? Now, you would assume you've got KV-2s, you've got IS-1s, these would be the most popular vehicles for the Russian side. No, they're not. Not even close. Most popular vehicles for the Russian side are the T-34-85 and the T-34-85D5T. Why are these machines more popular? Well, these machines carry an 85mm gun that's as good as the one that's on the Tiger, and they have two respawns. They're also vastly more mobile. Now, here's the kicker. You'd think, oh yeah, but they're medium tanks, they don't have a lot of armour. Tiger does, this is entirely correct, except the 85mm gun with APCR, or the high penetrator ammunition for the T-34-85s, will go straight through the Tiger like it's made of butter. Same as the shovel from the Tiger will go straight through the T-34-85 like it's butter. So one for one, the armour becomes largely irrelevant. The T-34s are more mobile, and you've got to fight two of them for every one Tiger. I have had battles on the ground where it has been 16 Tigers versus what is effectively 32 T-34-85s. Now, the German team, of course, does get its own medium tanks with multiple respawns. This is probably the best one. This carries a 75mm gun that, well, even with APCR, will bounce fairly regularly off the front of any of the T-34 variants, and is one-shottable from any angle. Now, here's the thing that bothers me with all this more than anything else, is this mode is supposed to be absolute simulator mode. This is supposed to be as close as Gaijin can make it to the real thing. I don't know about you, but I don't think there was a lot of respawning going on in real life during World War II. I'm pretty sure that when a T-34 was destroyed and its crew was killed, the T-34 stayed destroyed and its crew was killed. The second thing that needs to be done is that all respawns need to be removed from all vehicles within the game mode. You get one, and that's it. There is another thing that I've noticed within the ground forces. The vehicles that have the respawns, people that are on their first spawn, tend to be a little crazy with their tanks. They will throw them into situations that they really shouldn't be doing. I've even gone so far as to see medium tank drivers throwing their tanks into positions where they know they're going to die, just so they can scout and get a look at the tanks that are going on ahead, so their teammates can kill them while they're trundling back from their respawn in their second tank. That shouldn't be acceptable in this game mode. Now, yes, I am using mouse joystick here because I still don't have Track IR at this time. However, Track IR has been ordered. By the time you watch this video, I should have had it installed. So, yeah, this should be the last time you're ever seeing me doing this. I'm using mouse joystick and not my actual joystick, just because I can press C and I can look around like you see here. It allows me to be able to track targets on the ground. Trying to fly and a ground attack aircraft like the G1 Stuka, which is what I'm in here, without the ability to look around the cockpit and check out your side windows, it's near impossible. So don't worry, this will be the first and last time you see me fly with mouse joy. Slightly too far to the left. So, besides the respawns on tanks and those few adjustments to aircraft, honestly I have no further complaints with this game mode. I suppose if I get really nitpicky, the only other thing that I could really suggest that Gaijin do is, when you're driving your tank, you've still got the map in the bottom right-hand corner. Now, when you're in normal simulator battle and you're getting a ping on that map showing the location of enemy tanks, that map is useful to have on the screen. It's worth the screen real estate that it's taking up, just to have it there, because it's identifying targets for you. However, in this mode, that doesn't exist. So that map is offering you absolutely no useful information whatsoever. If I want to check the map and my location, I can just press M. Having the map there is, yeah, it's a waste of space. So I'd like an option. I imagine there's some people that like it there. I don't. I would like the ability to remove it. So maybe an option in the menu somewhere where you can turn the map on or off. Actually, putting some resize options would be nice as well. But I'm getting really picky when I come down to this. Now, that was more on aim. Those were bouncing, though. Now he's just about to pass into the city, he's the last tank on the enemy team, and as he passes into the town, I lose the ability to track him. This is what I was talking about by buying the tanks time to find the kind of cover that makes him hard to detect from the air. That guy's bright friggin' yellow and I can't see him anymore, he's just gone into the trees and vanished. And that's the kind of thing that removing the air spawn would allow tanks to be able to do. You know, if you drive out in an open field, you deserve to get the shit bombed out of you, that's just the way it works. But you don't deserve to get bombed to hell just because you spawned in the middle of an open field and the enemy aircraft was able to get to you before you could get to your first spot of cover. Now I do manage to spot him in here, fire a couple of shots, but he was smart, he went and ducked in behind a building and I couldn't keep the line on him, and he's disappeared again. As I turn the plane around, I'll lose him again. Honestly, that's really all I've got to say about this mode. Everything else is perfect. I love the interaction between planes and tanks. Having a four-man squad mixed was amazing fun. Being able to fly over the tank battles like this and not having any markers or any indicators or anything at all to give me any indication of where the enemy team is amazing, just being able to fly like this. This is great fun. And I think the popularity of this game mode, it shows. This is what your community wanted, Gaijin. This is what they've been asking for, and now you've delivered, we're happy. There's a couple of areas where it could be tweaked, obviously, to make it better, but that's the story with anything. But the game, this is great. This really is. Just scanning the central square here to see whether or not he's gotten into the center of town. And I think I catch a glimpse of him in between the buildings here, and it looks like he's actually trying to get back out of town, down the road, and into the forest. So, bring it back around, I'm moving to check. Now I'm alone up here at the moment, Semper Mortem is heading back to the runway, he's picking up a fresh bomb load and will be en route in just a few moments. I just get a glimpse of the tank, he was right there on the right hand side down the road, so I know where he is now and he's heading out towards the open field. He's trying to get to our cap point. Now we only have one Tiger left on the ground. He knows we're harassing the tank and so the Tiger has camped himself in on our spawn, waiting for the T-34 to come to him. Now this is one of the other great parts about this mode, although there's only one enemy tank here, so it should be pretty safe, and somehow all of those missed. But one of the great parts about this mode is without any target indicators or markers, and I've just killed my engine due to overwepping, oops. But as I was saying, from both the air and on the ground, you need to identify the enemy tanks yourself, and you need to identify friendly tanks yourself. You need to be able to tell the difference. If you're German, you need to know what your Panzers and your Tigers look like. You need to know what all of your German tank destroyers look like, and you need to know what your German aircraft look like. Then you need to be able to identify all of the Russian machines. The same works in reverse, so you know who your allies are and who your enemies are, because you don't get an indicator for any of this. Now this leads up to one final thing with this mode, and this is actually something that Gaijin can't fix, this is on the player base. This is on you, my subscribers, and everybody else. If you're going to get into this mode, if you're going to play this mode, I fully encourage you to do so, it's amazing. But please, please spend the time to learn the difference between German and Russian aircraft, and German and Russian tanks. Because what's about to happen here, this is not the first time it's happened to me. In either an aircraft or a tank. Now, my engine's just about to die. I've turned on the red smoke and I'm circling the T-34-85. I'm pretty clearly I'm not going to be able to kill it, but Semper Mortem is using me as a vector to get his D-5 here with the bomb load, and I just took a massive hit that just sheared the back section of my plane and damaged it, causing me to crash. What got me? A BF-110. This guy had no idea how to tell the difference between a Stuka and a Russian aircraft. He caused me to lose track of the target and therefore Semper Mortem lost his vector and we were unable to reacquire the tank until it got to our cap circle. Thankfully, that camping Tiger managed to locate it and execute it before it could cap out. So, results for the match. Second place for the team with 2 ground kills and 2 assists. Cost me 3 vehicles to do so, 1,267 points, a whole heap of awards. Most of that was from combinations of teamwork, 35,442 Silver Lions, and picked up 7,041 research points. But it is a premium tank, so So, what more is there to say about this game mode? I really bloody enjoy it. It's brilliant. I had a great time, and so did everybody else I was squatted with. I really hope Gaijin spend some more time just refining it and getting it all right. At the same time, I hope they constantly keep it up in the events mode until it goes live, and when it does go live, I hope they make sure it is as either a permanent event or a permanent replacement to simulator battles. I don't really care which, because this is just better than everything in every way. I love it, and I think a lot of other people too do as well. Anyways, ladies and gents, I hope you enjoyed this video. Click like if you do, subscribe if you want to see more. Drive smart, drive safe, and I'll catch you on the battlefield.